Greetings, beloved human family. I am Gilles Nancillon, and I'm guided to come to you today to speak very briefly of the integration of these new energies of the WebEx. But first, I wanted to thank you all from the bottom of my heart. I've been on YouTube for 2 years, and so I wanted to express my gratitude for your support, for watching those videos. If they mean anything to you, if this message can be integrated to raise your frequency, to increase the quality of your life, that's really what's most important, more than the videos. So this wave that just impacted the Earth, this third wave X, was very powerful. But if you didn't feel anything, do not be worried or concerned. If you feel like you're tired, just go to rest. If you feel like you have some physical pain, realize that it's not something chronic. It is just something temporary. Pass through it. There is a lot of reconfiguration, both within the brain and within all the cellular structure. So we have to go through, drink a lot of water, rest well. And so that will really help. So we cannot really miss those portals, although if we are fully conscious at the time of those infusion of new light into the electromagnetic field of the Earth that comes from the galactic center or the centers, then we are more able to fully integrate it, to fully participate. But then again, there will be more, and there is always more. And although the facade has not really changed, for the most part, it is a very slow progress. Internally, there's been a lot of changes, and this WebEx, I could see people on the street talking about past lives, or people that I know that would tell me a year ago that if the BBC didn't talk about it, it has to be a lie, it cannot exist, because everything that is true is being taught on the BBC. But even those people are opening their mind to the possibility that there is an invisible world, not yet on all the way to the spiritual plane, but there is a bit of opening from a lot of people that were kind of close to that before, and so this is a part of the effect of that wave. On July 26th, we're going to be moving into the Galactic New Year, so it is the fourth one. In 2012, we were born as a new spirit. Of course, it does not register or manifest just yet, but for now we've been through 4 years of that process of awakening our spiritual self. And so so we should be able by now, as 4 year old, to stand straight. That means to hold on to your light, to stand for your truth, to stand on to be able to face the world with your own light. And though, so it does not mean that you're going to be running around all over the universe yet, but to express that. But for now, it is important to be very creative. And to also express the light that you've discovered. It is a necessity when you discover something about the eternal, any aspect of that eternal light, you have to share it with others, express it in some way. Then we're going to be moving into the Lion's Gate, which is a very powerful portal of alignment with the galactic center. This year will be very potent, I'm sure. This summer is going to be a wonderful summer, all kinds of opportunities and fun and joy and happiness, if we are free to enjoy that. Then in September, Jupiter is going to move into Libra, which will, and there will be many, many events that will be, this September is a great shift in time, and then we're going to be moving into the 11-11 Stargate and 12-12 and the winter solstice. One thing that's important to understand is that we cannot analyze and understand everything that is happening, because it is beyond the rational mind. So it is important to allow yourself to let go and flow. As you let go and flow, you open your consciousness, you open your mind, the light comes, and your questions are being answered. So it is not, but the rational mind can only speculate, and so the speculation will never come up to anything real when it comes to the reality of the soul, because the soul is utterly beyond that limit, that linear path. So it is important to be very creative and to share whatever light you have. I've been asked some question about the law of one. Of course, it is an law that is infinite and eternal. It cannot be explained. But those approach of those four principles is one approach that could be put into practice. Of course, the Dharma Sutra, both in Hinduism or Buddhism, is also an attempt to understand the law, just as the Quran, the Torah, the Tao Te Ching, the New Testament. Those are sacred books that were given to help us understand this law of creation, in order to have to live better together, to understand to expand our consciousness towards more love, more compassion, more brotherhood, and so eventually this law will reflect on us until we are completely ready to rely on our inner light, inner understanding, inner guidance, and then we have to follow that. That is our true compass. The call, the voice from the heart, is the true compass that we need to always be attuned to and follow that as much as possible. I wanted to note that if sometimes I receive comments that are really nice, I want to respond to them, but I cannot always do that because of the questions, but because my software does not allow me, or maybe it's YouTube, I'm not really sure. So if you do have a question you really or something you want to communicate with me, please write me at gilmansillon@gmail.com. And so that I will make sure that I get that, and I'll do my best to respond as soon as I can. I'm going to pull four cards. This is a deck of cards that a friend of mine created with one of our guides that I know, a friend of mine too, whose name is Sonia Delaunay. And she's a great channeler, and she created those cards. I really love them. And so I'm going to pull four cards. The first card is what is your highest wisdom in the moment? It is the message from your master guide. And here you have completion. It means the completion of a cycle, the completion of whatever there is needs to be completed will bring the new. So it is important to make this completion possible, and so you'll be able to enjoy those new energies as well as prepare yourself for the new cycle. Then what you need to understand, which is the path of the earth, is empowerment. Card of empowerment. So empowerment is how to find your inner power in order to, it's not a power over anybody else, it's a power over yourself that gives you more power and more integration within the greater flow of life. The third card is what action do we need to take? And here we have master guide. So the action we need to take is to be connected to our master guide. This is a source of wisdom, Ishi, depending on who's your master guide. We all have different master guides. I have more than one master guide even because of some of my past life's incarnation. But there is one that is the main guide that it is someone you really want to know, you really want to be with, you want to be connected to, although those beings live on a much higher plane, so it's not easy for them to even communicate because of the great spiritual distance, so to speak. But they're always watching you. If you're in trouble, they'll know. They'll be there. They'll protect you. They'll guide you. When you're going in the right place, they will support you, assist you, propulse you, push you, and they're always available for guidance and wisdom. And so you do want to call on your master guide. Try to call on him or her, and then see who comes up, who comes to communicate with you. It may take time. Sometimes it may come in dreams, or it may come in many ways. So there is no right or wrong. It's just the way life is, just the way it is, and we have to deal with it each and every moment the best we can. And if we can infuse that understanding, that non-judgmental, attitude that allows to let go of our belief in order to receive a higher truth, then we can grow with that each and every day. And the general message for you is to create. It is very important to be creative, because creation is through creation that we, before anything, God is a creator. He's created the universe, He's created you, He's created me, He's created all of it. So, and this is your inner power, is to create. Of course, God is not asking us to create galaxies, but to create, to make this world a better place, or to communicate with your creative power, to be attuned, to be to find ways. It doesn't have to be art, it can be anything, it can be working in nature, in the kitchen, it can be, but just know that you are being creative, you are adding things, you are thinking of new things to do those things that you used to do, but you may be able to do it in a better way, in a more fun way, or because creation is fun. And so it is important. Personally, I'm very lucky in the sense that I've been for many, many years, I've been working on those spiritual paintings. And when I create those, it is a spiritual ascension process for me, as I am channeling higher energies, collective energies sometimes. And so those paintings have been really tremendous help for me. And at the end, you know, I have the pleasure of enjoying the company of those paintings, but it is always the new ones that creates the challenges that is the most exciting is what is coming up. No matter how good the past was, it is not something to be held on to. We have to move into something even better in the future, and so it shall be. So it is. So, on those words, I wish you a wonderful day. I thank you very much, and I will come back. I've been a bit distracted. I don't have time to do a daily video or anything. For life is meant to be a distraction, and I'm moving into a new level of my mission here on this earth. So I will make announcement as time goes on. But for now, I hope you enjoyed this video, and I'll talk to you later. Thank you very much. Namaste.